Now, they came together in Rockhampton and are now based in Brisbane. They've just won their first APRA award for Best Blues and Roots Work of the Year. And above all, they're mad keen rugby league fans. Let's take a look at them in action.
I'll go on forever, forever and a day. Right
there, Busby, Marou. Please welcome our special guests, Tom Busby and Jeremy Marou. Thanks very much for coming in, guys.
Thanks for having us.
Welcome to the Late News.
Great to have you here. Now, I've got to say, I love your music, and I love hearing and reading about the impact that you guys are having, specifically in and around Rockhampton. Tom, you've spoken about your ignorance in regards to Indigenous issues, but you feel that you're really making an impact.
Yeah, look, I think what it comes down to is, you know, I grew up thinking that, you know, I was doing the right thing all the time, and everyone around me also, you know, in White Rockhampton was doing the right thing as well. But
which is what? What do you
which
mean?
Which is basically not being racist or discriminative against, you know, and you know, Indigenous Australians. And we grew up basically together, you know, a white and a black Rockhampton. That's how it was. And
yeah.
That's how it always is. But
as in very separated, or
no. Like playing football together and going to school together, but just the treatment of it, you know, is looking back and reflecting on it, you know, it's I'm saying that in a way I think I was ignorant to the issues and perhaps, you know, I wasn't dealing or treating others the way I should be, and that's probably the problem.
Yeah. You guys are often labelled as an Indigenous band. Do you see yourselves, or do you call yourselves that as such?
No.
Well, it's pretty obvious why.
No, definitely not. I mean, just you see a black fella in a band, you go, oh, you're going to come to a Busby Marou concert and see island drums and didgeridoos. That's not the case. We, you know, we play music just like anyone else around. And yes, I've got some great cultural back, you know, influences in that you'll hear in the music, and that's what we enjoy doing.
I mean, at the end of the day, I'm a white fella, he's a black fella, he can play the guitar probably better than any white fella I've seen, and we play music together, and that's it, you know.
Yeah. So. But does it bother you, the labelling? I mean, the fact that that happens? I mean, is that, because does that really define what you are?
I guess I've got used to, you get used to the pigeonholing thing, but it doesn't really bother us. I guess we see ourselves as living examples that the whole reconciliation that black fellas and white fellas can get along. You know, there's a lot of ants around the whole thing, but we just see ourselves as we're it. We're a black fella and white fella that play music together, and it's, you know, we don't even see it as that, really.
Am I right in thinking you're Eddie Mabo's great nephew? Is that right?
Yeah, like that.
I mean, a lot has changed since that time. It's 20 years now. You must be quite proud of. Of that connection?
Yeah, definitely. And you know, I'm biased to say that Murray Island that you can see on the screen now is the best on the Torres Straits. And
you work for the tourism board.
That was great. I just saw that. But I'm very proud to say that's a part of my family. And I can take my kids back to, you know, Murray Island, the same beaches that he walked on, and say this is your land. Mm.
Do you think when he was going through that High Court battle? I mean, I just watched the film the other week. It was amazing. Do you think he was aware of what it meant more broadly and would mean over time?
Oh, absolutely not. You know, the High Court decision that triggered that legislation go through was based on a little island. Now you're looking at an entire country. We've got all the different Indigenous groups that are still trying to work out. And what we've got to remember is that, you know, when white settlement came, they took away a whole generation. So now it's starting again and working out who's from where, and it can get very complicated. So I think when he sort of won the battle for his little island, you know, nowadays it's you know, native title and the whole Mabo case is just massive. So it's a great thing.
Let's talk about your music. You're passionate musicians, but you're not musos. You just do it because you love it, yeah? That's fair?
Well, it's also fair to say that Jeremy hates musos.
Oh, I can't stand tight jeans, man. I can't stand tight jeans.
You hate hipsters too. Everyone hates hipsters.
No one likes hipsters. Who likes hipsters?
Don't say that word
hipsters
around
Hipsters don't
here.
Like hipsters. True, it is true.
You've got quite different musical tastes as well, don't you?
Yeah, we do. We had a bit of trouble with that, you know, early on in the piece. I'd bring all my music to Jeremy and he wouldn't, you know, he'd think I was a hipster. He wouldn't listen to it and vice versa, you know. But we eventually worked out that, you know, after a couple of years of fighting and trying to swap CDs, that it's our different influences that have created our style and sound, and, you know, we're fortunate for that now.
Tom, I see that shirt and I think of Dolly Parton.
which is
appropriate because you supported her.
Yeah,
you
we
made an
did.
Impression, sort of.
Well, yeah, I was wearing this shirt, actually,
in the photo
we got with Dolly Parton. It's my favourite shirt. I only wear it for important occasions.
What was it that happened at the end when she said you guys were great? Didn't she then ask who you were or something like that?
She said, we met her and we were very nervous. We were like school kids lining up and pushing each other out of the way.
You go first. Yeah.
And, you know, she's an amazing person. You know, we only met her for 3 minutes.
Yeah, she's made of plastic.
Yeah. Well,
she looks beautiful.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah, great.
But, I mean, I don't know. It was an interesting experience. We were pretty overwhelmed by everything at that stage. And, yeah, we said, oh, we supported you. Thank you for the support slot. And she, oh, what's your name? What's your old names? And then, Busby Marou. And then she walked away. She went, good luck in your careers. What's your old names again?
You clearly left a lasting impression.
Yeah.
Queensland is changing pretty rapidly. You still live in Rocky. You live in Brisbane. I mean, is it hard to kind of get a sense of where the state is culturally because it's changing so much? There's, you know, mining coming in, the demographics changing as well.
Yeah, I went back to Rockhampton recently, you know, for the first time in about 4 months, and things were very different there. You know, it's booming, but it's not the same old town that it used to be.
Mm. We're going to have to go to a break.
I just wanted to know, Jeremy, I know you love your music, but surely State of Origin is up there as well.
I'd rather be a footy player than a muse. I just wasn't good enough.
Really?
Definitely.
Can they do it?
Of course they can. All seven right. Coming.
Very quickly, what are you playing for us after the break?
A new single, I Still Don't Believe.
We're really looking forward to it. Thanks for coming in, Busby Marou.
Thanks for having us.
Nice to meet you. Now, they came together in Rockhampton and are now based in Brisbane. They've just won their first APRA Award for Best Blues and Roots Work of the Year. And above all, they're mad keen rugby league fans. Let's take a look at them in action.
I'll go on forever, forever and a day. Until you lose the interest, right then I'll walk away.
And they're Busby Marou. Please welcome our special guests, Tom Busby and Jeremy Marou. Thanks very much for coming in, guys.
Thanks for having us.
Welcome to the Late News.
Great to have you here. Now, I've got to say, I love your music, and I love hearing and reading about the impact that you guys are having, specifically in and around Rockhampton. Tom, you've spoken about your ignorance in regards to Indigenous issues, but you feel that you're really making an impact.
Yeah, look, I think what it comes down to is, you know, I grew up thinking that, you know, I was doing the right thing all the time, and everyone around me also, you know, in White Rockhampton was doing the right thing as well, but
which is what? What do you
which
mean by
is
that?
Basically not being racist or discriminative against you know Indigenous Australians, and we grew up basically together, a white and a black Rockhampton. That's how it was. And
yeah,
that's how it always is. But
as in very separated, or
no, like playing football together and going to school together, but just the treatment of it, you know, is looking back and reflecting on it, you know, it's. I'm saying that in a way I think I was ignorant to the issues and perhaps, you know, I wasn't dealing or treating others the way I should be, and that's probably the problem.
Yeah. You guys are often labelled as an Indigenous band. Do you see yourselves, or do you call yourselves that as such?
No.
Well, it's pretty obvious why.
No, definitely not. Look, you see a black fella in a band, you go, oh, you're gonna come to a Busby Marou concert and see island drums and didgeridoos. That's not the case. We play music just like anyone else around. And yes, I've got some great cultural influences in that you'll hear in the music, and that's what we enjoy doing.
I mean, at the end of the day, I'm a white fella. He's a black fella. He can play the guitar probably better than any white fella I've seen. And we play music together, and that's it. You know,
But does it bother you, the labelling? I mean, the fact that happens? I mean, is that, because does that really define what you are?
You get used to the pigeonholing thing, but it doesn't really bother us. We see ourselves as living examples that the whole reconciliation that black fellas and white fellas can get along. You know, there's a lot of ants around the whole thing, but we just see ourselves as we're a black fella and white fella that play music together, and it's, you know, we don't even see it as that, really.
Am I right in thinking you're Eddie Mabo's great nephew? Is that right?
Yeah, like that.
I mean, a lot has changed since that time. It's 20 years now.
Yeah.
You must be quite proud of that connection.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And you know, I'm biased to say that Murray Island that you can see on the screen now is the best on the Torres Straits. And
you work for the tourism board.
That was great. I just saw that. But I'm very proud to say that's a part of my family. And I can take my kids back to, you know, Murray Island, the same beaches that he walked on, and say this is your land. Mm. And
do you think when he was going through that High Court battle. I mean, I just watched the film the other week. It was amazing. Do you think he was aware of what it meant more broadly and would mean over time?
Oh, absolutely not. You know, the High Court decision that triggered that legislation go through was based on a little island. Now you're looking at an entire country. We've got all the different Indigenous groups that are still trying to work out. And what we've got to remember is that, you know, when white settlement came, they took away a whole generation. So now it's starting again and working out who's from where, and it can get very complicated. So I think when he sort of won the battle for his little island, you know, nowadays it's you know, native title and the whole Mabo case is just massive. So it's a great thing.
Let's talk about your music. You're passionate musicians, but you're not musos. You just do it because you love it, yeah? That's fair?
Well, it's also fair to say that Jeremy hates musos.
Oh, I can't stand tight jeans, man. I can't stand tight jeans.
You hate hipsters too. Everyone hates hipsters.
No one likes hipsters. Who likes hipsters?
Don't say that word
hipsters
around
Hipsters don't
here.
Like hipsters. True, it is true.
You've got quite different musical tastes as well, don't you?
Yeah, we do. We had a bit of trouble with that, you know, early on in the piece. I'd bring all my music to Jeremy and he wouldn't, you know, he'd think I was a hipster. He wouldn't listen to it and vice versa, you know. But we eventually worked out that, you know, after a couple of years of fighting and trying to swap CDs, that it's our different influences that have created our style and sound. And, you know, we're fortunate for that now.
Tom, I see that shirt and I think of Dolly Parton.
Which you stole
it. Which is appropriate because you supported her.
Yeah,
you
we
made an impression, sort of.
Well, yeah, I was wearing this shirt, actually,
in the
photo we got with Dolly Parton. It's my favourite shirt. I only wear it for important occasions.
What was it that happened at the end when she said you guys were great? Didn't she then ask who you were or something like that?
She said, we met her and we were very nervous. We were like school kids lining up and pushing each other out of the way.
You go first. Yeah.
And, you know, she's an amazing person. You know, we only met her for 3 minutes.
Yeah, she's made of plastic.
Yeah.
She looks beautiful.
Yeah, she does.
Yeah, great.
But, I mean, I don't know. It was an interesting experience. We were pretty overwhelmed by everything at that stage. And, yeah, we said, oh, we supported you. Thank you for the support slot. And she, oh, what's your name? What's your old name? Busby Marou. And then she walked away. She went, good luck in your careers. What's your old names again?
You clearly left a lasting impression.
Yeah.
Queensland is changing pretty rapidly. You still live in Rocky. You live in Brisbane. I mean, is it hard to kind of get a sense of where the state is culturally because it's changing so much? There's, you know, mining coming in, the demographics changing as well.
Yeah, I went back to Rockhampton recently, you know, for the first time in about 4 months, and things were very different there. You know, it's booming, but it's not the same old town that it used to be.
We're going to have to go to a break.
I just wanted to know, Jeremy, I know you love your music, but surely State of Origin is up there as well.
I'd rather be a footy player than a muse. I just wasn't good enough.
Really?
Definitely.
Can they do it?
Of course they can. All seven right. Coming.
Very quickly, what are you playing for us after the break?
A new single, I Still Don't Believe.
We're really looking forward to it. Thanks for coming in, Busby Marou.
Thanks for having
us. Nice to meet you.